Hello, Shippers, and welcome to yet another beer review with me, Peter, the Master of Hobbits, and Jakob Lord of Waltz. And today we're collabing yet another beer from Beer Here. This is the Beer Here Nordic Rye Ale. It says Danish farmhouse style ale on the bottle, and it's an 8%. And it's actually a traditional style ale because it's brewed in traditions of Danish ales. And the recipe was actually conceived together with Michael Jackson, the famous beer writer. This is one of the beer here beers I think you might be able to get in the States, because it says here that it's imported by the Shelton brothers. And it's brewed at Nøgne, just like their Dark Hops and Pumpernickel Porter,
which is in Norway.
Yeah, but I think people know that already.
Maybe not.
Maybe not. But Jakob found some info about the beer on the website.
A beer inspired by the old Danish godt øl,
which means good beer.
Good
beer.
That's
beer you drink for special occasions.
Yeah, as it was
a homebrewed good beer.
Yeah. As it was brewed on farms before brewing became industrialized. Godt øl was brewed for special occasions to be extra strong and nurturing from excessive use of raw materials. The recipe was originally developed in collaboration with the late Michael Jackson. Not the musician, for his rare beer club. Available in sometimes in 500 milliliter bottles and 30 liter 1-week kegs. Brewed from Maris Otter ale, malt, chocolate malt, rye malt, oats, and English and German hops, as well as water.
Super!
On 30 IBU and 8 ABV.
Yeah, 8% alcohol. Yes. So yeah, let's get it cracked open here. We had it at the beer festival, so it's going to be fun having it again, because that's been a while.
Yeah.
Here it is, and it's a, it kind of looks, we just reviewed the Scotch Ale Jameson sent us, and it's got kind of like the same color, though this is not as cloudy. It's kind of that golden, not golden, what am I saying? That
I'd say it's almost darker, but it's not.
A little darker maybe, but it's not hazy, you can see through it. I can see my fingers through it, at least when it's sold up to the dye, but it's like a brownish, dark, kind of reddish, kind of mahogany kind of, almost. With a three-finger, huge frothy, nice-looking, almost beige head.
Yeah.
And it looks like a head that's going to stick around, because look at that glaze it's already creating. But let's check out the aroma. Okay, first thing I pick up is rye.
Yeah.
Spicy rye quality. A lot of breadiness to it, too. Almost like rye bread.
Yeah.
It's got quite a lot of breadiness. It smells a little bit like a barley wine, but not as heavy.
Yeah.
Even though it's only 8%, but barley wines can be a lot more. But some maltiness in there. Maybe some... What? I was about to say chocolate malt. And that was probably also because you read it off the label. There's definitely a hot, faint chocolate malt note in there, but not like real chocolate, just like chocolate malt smell.
Yeah.
Darker fruits.
Kind of like cocoa.
Mmm. Light roasted, toasted, let's say that, like that, toasted note.
Yeah.
Some nutty notes in there too, and dark fruits. And it's got some berries too, I think. Some like forest berries, berries.
Yeah.
It smells like a malty, kind of wintry, autumn beer, so it's this
season.
Awesome evening, perfect. So let's give it a taste.
Cheers.
There's a lot of rye in the flavor.
Yeah.
This is one of the beers I've had with the most rye in the flavor.
Yeah. But it doesn't impede in any way.
No, it's actually quite nice. What would you call the body on it?
I'd say full. Bordering on medium. It's not full, but it's definitely there.
Yeah, I'd say more of a medium, close to full, actually.
Yeah.
But
a glass half filled, half full, half... Yeah. Yeah, half full, half empty. Yeah.
Lightly dry mouthfeel. It's got some spicy notes in there too. That's probably because of the rye.
Yeah.
I think. It's got some spicy notes along with the rye. Quite a little breadiness in there. Like a dark, hefty bread. And it feels kind of filling too. Which I'm guessing is because of the rye. I think it's kind of cool that he's recreated an old Danish kind of type of beer brewed in the farm. Pretty drinkable. I think style-wise, I would compare this to maybe a cross between a barley wine and a brown ale, maybe?
Yeah,
because it's got some light nuttiness too and lightly toasted notes.
Yeah, I'd say more of a barley wine than a brown ale.
Yeah, but it's still got kind of brown ale quality with the nuttiness and all. But it's actually quite nice.
Yeah. Definitely try this one if you want to.
Try some traditional Danish ale. That's
taste our heritage.
Yeah, taste our heritage. But yeah, what grade would you give this?
It's solid. It is, and I like the thought of renewing old beers.
What the fuck was that? Yeah. Was it just a big boom outside?
Yeah. Oh. I like the idea of renewing or reviving, rebrewing old beers.
Extinct
beers.
Like Adam beer, which is what Pair of the Dog Adam is.
And I especially like the thought of him doing a Danish style. Anyways, I will give this a 86.
Cool.
87 maybe. 86.
Cool. I was thinking 83. It's a pretty nice beer. Not the best beer I've had, but still pretty darn nice. And I also like the fact that it's a revived style of beer. So yeah guys, that's it for this beer review. An 83 from me, and an 86 from Jakob for the beer here, Nordic Rye Ale. Pretty good brew, definitely worth checking out. And if you're in America, you should be able to get this. Since it says it's imported by the Shelton Brothers, which is an import company in the US. Beer distribution company. So yeah guys, that's it for this review. Let us know what you think about the beer here, Nordic Rye Ale, if you've had it. And as always, remember to comment, subscribe, all that stuff, and we're gonna say cheers.
Cheers.
And we're gonna see you guys in another
beer review.
Yeah.